It's really a matter of great privilege for me to welcome all of you assembled here at development. The concern of the patients was always in his mind. He participated in the highest deliberations of the country. He represented his own community, his own class, but was always concerned with the nation, with the region as a whole. It is because of this and other important features of this dynasty. And one of the important features of the dynasty was that all the 19 persons who came to the Gaddi one after another were distinguished scholars, either of one branch of Sanskrit learning or of some other branch of Western learning. But whosoever sat in 16th century, in 17th century, 18th century, he was always a scholar, surrounded by the group of scholars in his court. And therefore, we felt when we started the activities of the foundation in 1996, we thought that we must celebrate the birthday of Maharaja Dhiraj, and on this occasion we must invite the really very great scholars who have international reputation in their fields to speak to the people here, to come to Mithila, to come to Darbhanga, see Darbhanga, and let Darbhanga people see him. This program has been continuing, and in this context we invited the great scholars, Dr. Deepankar Gupta and Dr. P.K. Bose. It's very difficult for me, at least, to choose the words for welcoming them. We all know how difficult it is. The travel has become both air and land travel. And coming to Darbhanga involves both air travel and land travel. And both are equally risky. And Darbhanga is virtually forcing a shell. Who comes to Darbhanga? Who knows Darbhanga in Delhi? In London? Though there are people who say that it's the age of globalization and every small place is known everywhere, even in the big places. But in the academic world, who knows? Who knows the world? Why should anybody come? I think it is their consideration, it is their love for the people of Bihar, for the people of Mithila, that they consider my request to come all the way. Did mind hazards, they won't mind the hazards on the trail back to Delhi and Calcutta. And they have been very kind to us. Sir, I'm really very grateful to both of you. Because you consider our request, you have come to Darbhanga, a remote area, in the first time, an obscure or ignored place. But we have honored the community, we have honored the community. And this for this, the community will always remember you. The foundation will always remain in the good place of you. I welcome both of my distinguished guests with a few words. And I welcome all of you. This program has been continuing for the last 15 years or 16 years. And it is purely because of your cooperation, your love, your affection, that I have been able to conduct it. Otherwise, we all know how difficult it is to call some people and honor them, to do some atithya for them. At the present moment, either in the villages or in the towns of our region, how difficult. But it has not been difficult at all, because you people have always cooperated. You have always extended cooperation. You have always stood in the days of crisis, in the hours of crisis, in the moments of crisis. So I welcome all of you, and I hope that your cooperation, the foundation, will have the opportunities to welcome you again and again. And your suggestions have often been incorporated. Whatever we could do, whatever we can do, we'll do. But please remain kind to us. Your kindful attitude is really the lifeline for us. I welcome you very, very sincerely. I welcome the representatives of the media who always covered our program very generously, very truthfully. These lectures are delivered. Our plan has been that through these lectures by the experts, the knowledge of social sciences or history or any discipline should go into the masses, into the public. Because this is one way that it can reach out. This precious knowledge can reach out to the public, to the general people, through this medium. This is one of the important sources. And in this connection, the role of the media is very, very crucial. I welcome them, and I am very grateful to them that they have been covering our programs, and they have been truthfully reporting what is said here, what is delivered here to the people. I again welcome all of you, and like every year, this year also, we have published one book in the Bihar Heritage Series, Kamiswati Bihar Heritage Series. The name of the book is Notes on the District of Bihar. The author of this book was George A. Grierson, a very well known name in the field of linguistics, folklore studies, who contributed a lot to our knowledge of our own society, of our own culture. He wrote this book in 1892, and the book was published in 1893. The book became so important, it includes the accounts of the conditions of the poorer classes, poor peasantry, laboring classes. It gives a very elaborate graphic details of how the irrigation system worked in there. That was an indigenous system. It narrates the texts of all the legends which were prevalent in those days in the rural areas of Magadha region, including the legend of Lodi, which also prevails in our areas, which prevails in most of the areas of North India. And credit goes to Grierson, who collected the original text that prevailed among the people, in the oral tradition of the people. The first text of Lodi Gatha was reported in the 14th century, precisely in 1379 AD, by Maulana Daud in his famous work Chandayan, that is the first Indo-Sufi Masnavi. Maulana Daud had covered the entire text, which prevailed at that time in Uttar Pradesh, in the second half of the 14th century. Then, after 14th century, it was Grierson in the second half of the 19th century that he collected the text, he reported the text, which prevailed in the Magadha region in the second half of the 19th century. This book became a matter of controversy in the British Parliament soon after its publication, and then the colonial government appointed Stevenson Moore to conduct the inquiry again about the conditions of the lower classes in Gaya and Magadha India. It became controversial. Later on, O'Malley elaborately commented on this. Then again, in the second half of the 20th century, P.C. Rai Chaudhary commented on it. Gyan Prakash, a great historian, he also worked on Gaya, and he also commented on this part. And finally, in the 21st century, a group of scholars like Prasanna Chaudhary and Srikant, they also wrote on this. So this book is a very important treasure of knowledge of Bihar, the conditions of Bihar. But unfortunately, by 1930s and 40s, Sachidanand Sinha, one of the makers of modern Bihar, he reported that this book has become extinct. It is not available in the market. In London also, it is available at a very high cost. And the scholars interested in Indian economics find it very difficult to procure a copy. When we realized that the book is so important, and when we started searching out a copy for publication, it was not available. Prasanna Chaudhary and Srikant, they have their own copies, but those copies were incomplete, fragments. So then we approached the India Office Library in London. They obliged us, they sent a soft copy, and then we have been able to publish the whole account. So this will be, the lokarpan of this book will be done by our guests. But unfortunately, I must say that the copies of the book have not been released by the binder. It will soon come, in a week or so, and then it will be distributed to all of you. But so far, we have decided that the lokarpan must be held. So two copies, somehow other have been managed, and we'll do the lokarpan on these two copies. The rest of the copies will follow. Now, I will request the guests to do the lokarpan. The notes on the